Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial about optionals. That's right, we are going to force unwrap and a lot of other stuff with optionals. So I want you to hit that subscribe button and let's dive in. So what are optionals? Today we are going to jump deep into optionals and to give you an awesome example. We are going to use first name, middle name and last name. And why we are going to use that? Well, many people have first name and last names, of course, but many don't have middle names. Some may have, some may not. And that is what we're going to use the middle name as an optional. Now think of optionals as a box that might contain something in it or might not. And when it is empty, we represent that with a nil value. So we want to know how to do that in code. So we just append a question mark on upon string, and we are going to use the middle name as the optional, as I told you. Now, how do you handle these optionals? Because from a server you might get back something or you might get back nil, and there are a lot of cases you see that there is an optional there when you receive something, and there are certain ways that you can unwrap these optionals, and I will go through them, and there are some safer ways to do that. But let's just jump right into the brute force unwrapping, which is not recommended at all. If you 100% know that this will not return a nil value, that is when you want to use force unwrapping, or when you basically want to crash your app if there is a nil value that you are unwrapping. And that is not most of the cases. So let me just show you how to force unwrap. Well, you just type in the name that you want to force unwrap onto, and we are just going to have this middle name. And as you can see, the string has question mark there, and that means that is an optional. And we are just going to use the exclamation mark or bang to unwrap it. Now, if we just hit build now, we are going to have an error here because we haven't added any values to our middle name. As you can see, execution has interrupted, and you get that unexpectedly found nil while unwrapping an optional value. Now, if we add here, and let's see here a string like bending, and build and run again, you see that here we have bending. So we have a value for our optional middle name. Okay, so that will not crash our app if we force unwrap it. And comment down below in the description, under comments, if you know the reference, what I'm talking about, bending. Okay. But this is really, really not the way that we should do things like force unwrapping. So there are a few ways to unwrap our optionals. And the first one is the if let unwrapping. And basically we are going to create a new name, like if let name equals middle name. And as you can see again, here is our string. And if this really is unwrapped, then we can just simply print out our name. Okay, else we can do something else, or rather not do, or just let the program run through it. Okay, now let's just build this out, and as you can see, we will have here a nil and nothing is printed out. If we just type in here print, like, let's say middle name is nil, let's just use string interpolation here, so we can use our middle name. Okay, so let's just build out now, and you will see that it's complaining that string interpolation produces a description for an optional value, and we should use string describing this string. Let's just fix that, and now you can see that middle name is Neil. Now, if we add again here, like bending, and run it again, build it again, we'll see that now the print statement is here and it's printing out bending. Okay, that is pretty great. Now we want to use, and it has some use cases, but in most cases you want to use guard let. So guard let is basically guarding against the nil value, and let me just delete this so we can have a good example. So start typing in guard let. We are going to create again the name equals middle name, and else we also want to return. So this is basically when you kind of guard let unwrap the errors. Maybe you have some errors, maybe you don't. If you guard let an error, then you just you just return here, but it is invalid. Let me just, yeah, you need to be in the function. So let's create a function like dummy func. Okay, and now let me just move this up. And here's a cool trick: if you hit Option Command and square brackets, you can move everything up. Okay, that line that you have selected. Okay, let's just see. Yeah, the name value isn't used, but that's okay. Let's just stop this and play it again. And now you will see that everything works okay. Let's just print out the name. There we go. Okay. And again, let's stop it and play it. Now, the name will not be printed out because the middle name is nil. And as you can see, we already have this nil. Okay, now we could print out again a print statement in before the return. But to see this work, let's just give that back bending. Okay, and just stop and play again. And you will see that here we should have, yeah, and we need to call that dummy function, of course. So dummy func. Okay, let's just do that and build it. And you can see bending. And if we just remove and let it be nil, we won't have that printed out at all. Okay, that is guard that unwrapping. And if this was an error, then you could just print out the error and return. You won't do anything else after this line of guard let unwrapping. Okay, now let's just move on to our optional chaining. Now, this is not unwrapping or something like that. You already know that enough with if let and guard let and maybe force unwrapping. But let me just show you a little more about optionals. And this is called optional chaining. Now, let me just create a person here like Alex. Let Alex equals our person guy here. And it has a first name, middle name, and the last name. And as you can see, the middle name is an optional. So first name, Alex. Let me have that as capitalized. And for the middle name, I will pass in nil for now. And you can see we can have, because I don't have a middle name. And for the last name, my last name. Okay, now if we just print out our Alex's first name, as you can see, that's a string. That's okay. So let's just see how this works. As you can see, it's Alex. That's great. Now, if we just try to print out our middle name, you already see that that is a string, and it will complain that we should use string describing and so on, or we could just force unwrap, or we just need to guard let unwrap it. But let me just build now, and you will see that this is basically a nil value, and it is printing out, of course, nil here. So let's just see how this optional will look. If I type in here, bending, let's build and run. And you can see that it is basically an optional. And that is why it is asking us to use string describing string or unwrap it if we wanted to. And yeah, this Alex middle name, and if we just create let name equals Alex dot middle name is an optional. And that is really, really good, because now we can use this as an optional, and then we can move on to use this name, like maybe with a guard let statement. So guard let name equals name, this optional name. Let's see, else return. Or let's just use if let, because we need a function here. If let name equals name, then let's just print out our name. And now when I just type this out, you will see that this name is not an optional at all. So let's just print that out and you will not see. Maybe let's just leave this commented, uncommented. So we can see that the first one is optional and the second one is not optional. Now, how awesome is that? Now you know basically everything, or 99%, that you need to know about optionals. So that's all about optionals. Now I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, I will be talking about protocols and delegates. Now, while you wait for that, make sure to check out these videos as well. I talk a lot about Swift UI, iOS development, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.